Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in yet another presentation inside the Word of God, and praying that the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus continues to give you the wings of protection, the protection of His grace and mercy, the divine mercies, the endurance throughout the afflictions of warfare, the torments of warfare, the perseverance, the resilience, the faith that is invested in every believer. Today I've been assigned by the Holy Spirit once again to present yet another warfare presentation, and I'm praying that at the end of this presentation I would have buried the enemy once again. Today I want to expose and to dethrone and to destroy what the Holy Spirit addressed unto me midnight and said, address the leak of sexual erotic mermaids. The sexual erotic mermaids. Oh yes, you heard me. I'm going to be exposing the sexual erotic mermaids. I'm not only going to be exposing the sexual erotic mermaids, I'm going to be dethroning them and I'm going to be destroying them in the realms. But before I even go any deeper in this dimension, let us go to the book of Genesis chapter 6 verse 1. And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them. The question is, Genesis 6 is not the Genesis of the scriptures, neither is it the Genesis of the Bible, neither is it the Genesis of the story of salvation. So the multiplication of men is supposed to happen in the book of Genesis, meaning that there was a multiplication of another race, another tribe, another dimension, another DNA of men. Why? Because earlier in the scriptures, Adam and Eve have been presented. I'm going to just briefly narrate so that I don't take long before releasing the bombshells upon the camp of the enemy. Adam and Eve have already been presented. Eve has already been presented from the loins of Adam. And Adam is representing the seed of God, representing the creation of God from the loins of God. Adam is representing the image and the likeness of God. And that was before the sin. That was inspired by the serpent. And the serpent that came in the garden, I explained it in the previous presentations, that the serpent actually had two legs to walk into the garden and deceive Eve, meaning that the serpent became intimate with Eve. But the question is, where was this serpent which deceived Eve? Where was it coming from? It was walking from a certain location to another point of location. And which point of location was this serpent coming from? The serpent comes from the family of the dragon, the same dragon, the seven-headed dragon which fell. And the seven-headed dragon represents the family of Leviathan. Leviathan is a dragon sea monster from the sea kingdom. And the sea kingdom is represented by all the earth, which was covered by water in the book of Genesis, which is the actual genuine genesis of the whole matter. God separated the waters beneath and the waters above, and created the firmaments, which is a realm which contributes water that is unseen, which is responsible for the scientific explanations which you study in science. And then there is water that was covering the surface of the earth. That water was separated and dry land was created. Whilst all that was happening, that was before the dry earth, where God then declared the Eden garden, where Adam was then created. Meaning that before the creation of Adam, we are talking about the fallen nature, the fallen entities that fell into the seas, that fell into the waters that were covering the whole surface of the earth. Meaning that there is a case study concerning the creatures that fell into the seas. Which creatures those were, and which invisible creatures those creatures were, which then fell into the waters that were covering this whole earth way before God separated the waters and created the dry land. And now we have Eden, and now we have Adam and Eve, and now we have a serpent. Where is the serpent coming from? The serpent had a tail. It always had a tail, but by then it could walk into the garden from another location. And then the scripture that I read unto you, which is in Genesis chapter 6 verse 1, it reads saying, and it came to pass when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and the daughters were born unto them. Meaning that the daughters which were born unto them, they were not daughters that were existing. Why? Because the woman who represented the mother of all living was Eve. Even though she had fallen, we did not hear about other women. We only know of Cain and Abel. And Cain is the one that then met at his brother Abel. And then Cain traveled to a certain city, to a certain land, in the land which was called Nod. And when he arrived there, he impregnated a woman. Where did that woman come from? That is case study number two. I asked you earlier about where did the serpent which deceived Eve come from. It comes from the same tribe where Eve's son, who is the fallen nature from the Garden of Eden, who is called Cain, traveled back to the same city where the serpent came from. The same serpent that was then cast in the garden and told that it would slide. It is from the family of Leviathan. It is from the family of the sea monster. It is from the family of Lucifer, the devil, who is known as the serpent, that serpent of old. And when Cain arrived in that dimension, Cain became intimate with one of the creatures that represents the fallen. These creatures, they represent different dimensions. There is a passage in scriptures which talks about an angel which would come down to trouble the pool in Bethsaida. It was not an angel. I explained it so many times. Why? Because the people that would gather there, they would get healed by condition that the first that would jump into the pool would get healed. There was a mermaid that would come out and trap waters. Why? Because there is no immortal angel that can trap waters that are liquids. So it was something that was physical that would appear at a certain specific time, and it would trap the waters. And the one that would step in first would get healed. So that gives us evidence that whatever came from the sea, which was the dimension in that dispensation, then it became intimate with Cain, and Cain became the ruler of that dimension. When Cain became the ruler of that dimension, Cain became intimate with one of the mermaids. They are called also sirens. And the scripture then says, the sons of God who were operating in the realms by then, they had the capacity to descend upon this earth and ascend. The moment that Cain is getting defeated here, the sons of God, they also got defeated. Then they also descended upon this earth and they entered into the daughters of men. They are now being described as the daughters of men, but these are not the daughters of men. These are evil mermaids. These are evil sirens. They entered into the daughters of men. But when they entered into the daughters of men, these were not daughters of men. These were fallen angels that entered into the seas before the rivers and the dams and the oceans, way back when the earth was still covered by water. If you go back to the book of Genesis chapter 1, you get that evidence. Why? Because you cannot convince me that those were ordinary daughters of men that were able to seduce the sons of God. They were not ordinary. But those were not only ordinary daughters of men. They were also giants that had fallen into the same seas. They were also strongholds that had fallen into the same seas. So they deployed the so-called daughters of men according to scripture context. When they deployed the daughters of men, they deployed the sirens, they deployed the mermaids. And by then the mermaids had the ability of walking out of the sea. Meaning that there is a classification of mermaids, human creatures that existed in the dimensions or in the realms of the waters. They were able to walk out of the sea. And when they will be able to go back into the sea, they develop the fish tails, they develop the serpent tails. The problem is that when you start preaching like this, you believe that you are extracting this information from movies. And then when we invite you to the ascension room to witness these things that we are preaching, to witness the things that I'm exposing, you don't want to turn up. But when I preach deep things like this, you start referring me to a series. You start referring me to a movie. I'm not preaching a movie. I'm not preaching a series. Because I'm preaching things that I can be able to expose at any given time of the day. Now, the sons of God that were in the realms, they descended upon the so-called daughters of men, but these are sirens. And then when they entered into the daughters of men, they also became the fallen. And if there was a crossbreed, I explained about this dimension, the dimension of crossbreeds. And there were mighty men, giants, men of renown, that were birthed, who were rebellious in the same attitude that Cain had. Cain was rebellious. That's the reason why Cain killed his own brother Abel. So there was a seed and a loin. The genealogy of Cain with the sirens, with the mermaids. Then the genealogy of the fallen sons of God with the mermaids. Those are two different dimensions. So we have got almost three categories of mermaids. Mermaids that represent the serpent dimension. Mermaids that represents the creatures of the sea. It could be a mermaid that represents an octopus. It could be a mermaid that represents the fish. It could be a mermaid that represents the mermaids from the pit of hell. They are mermaids that represent the sea. Mermaids that are pure, which are the real custodians of the sea. Those ones, they were already dethroned when the fallen entered into the seas. I'm not saying there is a holy mermaid. I'm not saying there is a righteous mermaid. All I'm saying is that right now here, even on the dry earth, there are human beings that are possessed by demons. And there are human beings that have got the Holy Spirit. And they are ordinary citizens, which are mere human beings. So human beings are in different diversities. But how the devil was able to conceive his evil nature was through crossbreeds, causing another tribe to become intimate with another tribe. Different dimensions of representations of creatures in the realms becoming intimate. These seas and dams, they are not only in the physical realm, they are also in the realms of the spirit. So the sons of God, they got defeated in the seas, in the realms, and they located the so-called beautiful daughters of men, and they were trapped by the sirens, which represented the marine kingdom, and they descended upon this earth and they became intimate. When they became intimate, the intimacy evolved many immoralities. That's where the birth of sexual immorality began. That's where the definition of sexual immorality began. That's where the origins of bisexuality began. That's where the origins of homosexuality began. All evil, all filthiness, all uncleanliness that you can ever imagine, that's where it began, in those realms of the spirit. And there was a crossbreeding between men and demons. There was a crossbreeding between angels and demons. There was a crossbreeding between the sons of God and the daughters of men. There was a crossbreeding between the angels and the mermaids. There was a crossbreeding between different creatures. And God saw that the earth had become so evil. And then he introduced Noah. But I don't want to rush into that dimension. This is why you realize that in Sodom and Gomorrah, the city had become so evil to the level that the two angels that had entered inside the house of Lot, there were men outside that wanted to sleep with those two men. But why did Lot say, I can give you my daughters? He knew the tribe which his daughters were coming from. Why? Because these are the two daughters that then slept with the Lot on two separate nights after he got saved. Meaning that the Lot was supposed to get rid of those two daughters. Why? Because they represented the daughters of men. They represented the sirens. They represented the mermaids. Where did the daughters of men come from? We hear of Eve. And before Eve, we hear of the mother of all living. After Eve, we hear of Cain and Abel. Where did the daughters of men come from? Who did Cain become intimate with? It was not Eve. It was not Eve, his mother. It was not even from the loins of the third born. Who was the Seth? When we follow the Seth line, we don't find any evil creation or any evil dispensation. I'm talking about the mermaids. There are mermaids that were ascending from the bottomless pit of the sea. There were mermaids that were ascending from the seas, and they would walk on the dry earth. Those are the mermaids that became intimate with Cain. Those are the mermaids. Those are the mermaids that became the daughters of men. Those are the daughters of men that became intimate with the sons of God. Those are the ones that coordinated with the giants. They gave birth to the giants. These giants are from the sea. Any giant that you are dealing with, any stronghold that you are dealing with is from the sea. is from the sea. All those giants that you're dealing with in the realms, even the giants that are in charge of the territorial strongholds, they're coming from the sea. Why? Because this dry earth came after the separation of the waters that were covering the earth. The sons of God saw that the daughters of men were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose. And the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with many, for he is also flesh. And this frustrated God. Why? Because men had become so carnal. Indeed, they were now men. But these men, they were no longer the immortal beings. They were now carnal. This is where the origins of carnality began, meaning that Adam was able to teleport both in the spirit and in the physical, meaning that Cain, even though he was fallen, he was able to communicate with God. Remember the part when Cain says, am I my brother's keeper? This is the level of relationship. This is the level of interaction that the dimension of Adam, the early loins of Adam, ate with God. But the dimension of the creation that has been presented does not hear God. It is a seed of the serpent. It is a seed of the dragon. It is a seed of Leviathan. It is a DNA from the sea. It is the DNA of the serpent that became intimate with Eve. The serpent that became intimate with the evil was a king from the sea. And that king from the sea was from the family of the mermaid with the serpent tail. But it was a king that seduced Eve and exposed the loins of Adam. And Cain went back to the tribe that represented the DNA of the serpent that became with the loins of the father. The DNA of Adam was interrupted, was corrupted by Eve when Eve committed adultery with the serpent from the sea. The serpent from the sea was the mermaid. The mermaids were already there. They are called mermaids in different descriptions, in different categories. I told you of the mermaids with the serpent tails. I told you of the mermaids, the natural creations of God, half men, half creatures. I told you of the mermaids under the marine kingdom. Just like I defined men and women of different kingdoms on the dry earth. So they were now bringing the corruption from the sea to the dry earth. And they waited for God to separate the waters that were covering the whole earth. So when the sons of God are entering into the daughters of men, they are becoming intimate with the fallen. When the sons of God are becoming intimate with the mermaids, they are having sex with the marine kingdom. Lucifer is having sex with the DNA of God through the serpent. This is why the marine kingdom is the most powerful, but not the most powerful above the sons of God. We represent the generation of the resurrection of the sons of God. We represent the generation of the sons of God that don't get defeated by these mermaids. We represent the generation of the sons of God that does not get defeated by the marine kingdom. We represent the generation of the sons of God that is here to rebuke homosexuality, that is here to rebuke bisexuality. We are here to represent the army of God. And God saw that the wickedness of men was great on earth, and that every imagination of men was evil continually. And God repented from having created men. God repenting. Why would God repent? Just because men became intimate with a woman? No. But because his creation was now becoming intimate with the enemy that was now fallen. His creation represented by the loins of Adam that were now defiled through Cain, becoming intimate with the fallen. The Bible does not give you specific identities of creatures, specific identities of certain descriptions of creatures like mermaids. It doesn't. It needs revelation and proof of revelation. That's the level where we need something that is more than scriptures. And we demonstrated that in the ascension room. The mermaids, they are still functioning. Recently I was driving out mermaids. And whenever they manifest, they join two legs of a human being. Why? Because the mermaids had two legs. Why? Because the serpent that was cursed in the garden, it had two legs and it started slithering with a tail, but it had two legs. So the genesis of a serpent having two legs is not forgotten in the realms. It can still be seen in the spirit. This is why a serpent can still come walking. But in the physical, you see a serpent sliding. What I'm preaching here is not for people that went to a Bible school. It's for people that function in the realms. These mermaids are the same mermaids that are still sleeping with the sons of God. These mermaids are the mermaids that are responsible for homosexuality. These mermaids are the same mermaids that are representing bisexuals. You cannot tell whether this is a girl or a boy, this is a man or a woman. Those are mermaids. You'll know them when they manifest. These are the mermaids that introduced sexual immorality on the dry earth. These are the mermaids that have introduced adultery and fornication. These are the mermaids that are committing sexual sin. These are the mermaids that are acting pornography. These are the mermaids I'm here to destroy. These mermaids, Lekoshi Prokosikata. And God then raised Noah. God repented that he had created men. Why? Because there was no longer men. Men had been dethroned. Men represented a God in this dimension, but he now knew both good and evil. He was not supposed to know both good and evil. He's now sleeping with the fallen creation. And God sent a flood that wiped the entire earth, and the earth went back to the first creation, to the first presentation, to the first dimension where water was covering this whole earth. And God restarted the formula, and the ark of Noah rested on a certain mountain. This was not the end, child of God. This was the beginning of war. Why? Because after that dimension, Noah lay in the tent naked, the same nakedness that exposed Adam and Eve. Noah also lay in the tent naked, and the curse continued to follow the loins of the sin of Adam. The sexual immorality continued. Why? Because when God sent the flood, he wiped away the giants, the mighty men, in the physical, not in the spirit. There was still a second Adam that was needed, but the one that wrote these words in this passage was Enoch, the seventh after Adam. But there was needed the second Adam, who was not a fallen being, who was later to come, whose name was Jesus, who was going to represent a dimension of the resurrection of the sons of God. And he has already came, and we are here representing the tribe of Enoch that exposed the daughters of men, representing the tribe of Enoch that represents the dimension that is beneath, the dimension that is above that exposes the dimension that is beneath. Likozi proshiketa. Krizepia kosokota. Likosiketa. Any homosexuality that you know, any bisexuality that you know, any fornication that you know, evil mermaids, evil sirens, evil fallen sexual demons, they are under the sea. They are represented by different categories of mermaids, but the most evil ones are the mermaids with the serpent tails, with the black eyes. Rika pashaka deba kosokota. Bea pashiklezi bea koti preapa. I dethrone every mermaid creature. I dethrone every giant in the realms of the seas, in the firmaments. Preapa kosiklezi bea kotepa. I dethrone mermaids, evil mermaids. All categories of mermaids that have been hijacked, and fallen angels that portray to be mermaids, and the daughters of men, the cursed serpents, the cursed fish under the sea, the cursed fowls of the air that represent the seas in the firmaments. Lea preshikata pakosiata. Piamakate prakosiklezi miosokota. Jakozi piakaseketa. Lege prakosokota. I come from the tribe where we don't surrender. I come from the tribe where we don't surrender. We continue warring in the realms in the name of Jesus.